is a presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll-free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Oh, look, oh, it's a beautiful day. Look at our man, Jim from Minneapolis. We're going to take it by storm.
Taking it by storm, baby.
I love that. That's a great saying, man. Hey, what's happening, brother?
Good morning, gentlemen. How you guys doing today?
Good, man. Yourself?
Oh, man. It's been the most incredible couple of days since when I called in on Friday, Litecoin busted out of that consolidation on the two-hour chart.
Okay.
And it just never looked back. It did a 100-point ABC up, and now it's very extended the way I look at it. But
yeah.
Holy I mean, it went up to $420 last night.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night, folks. Always do your best. Express your own divinity. You don't need the acceptance of others. You don't need knowledge or great philosophical concepts. You have the right to be you and to express your own divinity by being alive, loving yourself, and loving others. Alive and kicking, baby. It's where it's at. Market-wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials up 147. NASDAQ up 24. S&P's up 13.5. Gold contract up $5, trading at $13.38 an ounce. We have silver up 7 cents, $14.86 an ounce. Let's go over and take a look at that silver market. Because silver, finally, folks, has got its head above the water, and you get some real good juice behind this baby. We had broken the downtrend a couple days ago. Silver had caught the bid, you know, had some nice volume out here, broke the downtrend. Yesterday, you had 132,000 contracts. We get 75 today. Nice setup. Did reject that lower price out here this morning of 1473. Silver now also wants to gun for this 1638, which is the highs of February 20th. Gold, same type of setup. Light sweet crude. Light sweet crude right now trading up $1.12. You're at 5278. We get over and we take a look at that crude market. Crude out here today. Had a low of $51, a high of $53.18. Right now, you've done, let's get this volume for you. Okay, so we've done 718,000, which is not bad. Yeah, bottom line, you're going into a million contracts, but not bad. Didn't get over the high of yesterday yet, so that baby still looks to me that it does want lower price, meaning the 44 handle inside that contract. XLE, the XLE got over the highs of yesterday. It's coming right into the downdraft from $61.02. That's the number to keep your eye on. We had 23 million shares trade at that price point. Right now, you're at 14 million. Notes and bonds. Bottom line, notes and bonds, they continue to want higher price. We take a look at the 30-year out here. 30-year, let's see, U.S. USU 9. Okay, so the 30-year right now is trading up 7 ticks. You have done 336,000 contracts. That's still good contract volume as you're pushing into the highs. I expect we're going to build a little bit more cause up here, you know, because we had a heck of a move. There's no doubt. You know, you go back just a half a month, you know, well, basically 21 days. Let's say almost a full month trading-wise. The 30-year was at 145.11. Right now, you're at 153. You still have the 10-year trading out at 2.119. And King Dollar. King Dollar, folks, okay? High volatility inside King Dollar out here. No two ways about that. We've had King Dollar trade from high today of 97.990. We're at 96.985. The low today was 96.720. You've already done 27,000 contracts. So bottom line is that we have real sellers now inside the dollar. You know, the dollar had made a high on the 30th of May. We did that high with 7,000 contracts. You come off that high with 19,000, 29,000, 25. We did 25 yesterday, and we're 27 today. So I expect what we're going to see out here is that you're going to see the good old King Dollar make its way down to this 94 level. Now, if we get over and take a look at the indices, bottom line is that it looks to me like you get that ABC structure setting up, and it's kind of a classic one. This contraction today in volume is going to be pretty dramatic, and I expect what you're going to see is that the C is going to set up probably tomorrow morning. We're coming right into where you get a small gap at 285.10. We hit 284.64. We're going to take a look at the small caps. Let's go take a look at the IWM. IWM out here, that is down 74 cents. This one's going to be interesting, man, if it can't even get into the gap. See, the gap on the IWM is 152. Yesterday, we made it to 150.52, so 2 points away from it. NDX 100, what we have with the NDX, NDX out here, three Qs. You'll see the contraction of volume. I expect that's going to get a little bit higher also. We can even get 178.06. That's what I'm looking for. That's ICE inside the NDX 100. And the contraction of volume is huge, folks. There's no two ways about that. You have the contraction of volume out here. You know, on Tuesday, we did 47 million shares. Yesterday, you did 34 million. We'll find out if we can even do 30 million today. Right now, you're at 20 million. So, good number. GDX, we take a look at the GDX out here inside some of these gold stocks. GDX, bottom line, up 25 cents. This is building cause to get up into that swing high of 23.70. Right now, you're at 22.88. If we take a look at the GLD, which trades at 10% of the price of gold, you're going to see the GLD bottom line hit 126.45, and that high that it's going after is the 127.21. XAU, HUI also continue to catch a bid out here. XAU right now trading 74.49. Gold Bugs Index trading 168. Let's go take a look at the platinum market. Platinum, let's see. So I'll do the July contract. Okay, so spreading platinum out here today. Look at this. Oh, I see. Interesting. Look at platinum, man. That gave that. Yeah, let's look at this, because platinum gave it up, as did gold and silver yesterday. The difference is that they came right back. Well, it's not a bad setup. Platinum yesterday gets to a price point of 823. You do 27,000 contracts. You get 17 in the pullback. You know, platinum still, it broke that downtrend on Monday, and that's saying, now the downtrend I'm talking about is not the downtrend from the top of April. The downtrend here would basically give you like an 857. That number there, I'd say it's like the May 7th deal. You need, actually, one second, hold it. Maybe we did break that yesterday, and then we broke it and came back underneath it. Yeah, it's a close call. No, I'll stick with the, yeah. You really broke the downtrend from like the 881, not from the very high. Stay right there, folks. Come right back. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. We have the Dow up 153, NASDAQ up 28, S&P's up 14.5. Come right back.
Folks, Tom O'Brien here. If you'd like to get my daily newsletter, Market Insights, then now is a great time to sign up for a 30-day free trial. Every morning by 9:30, I send out my morning letter to subscribers with market commentary on a variety of markets, currencies, and commodities to keep investors up to date on the day's trading action. Included in Market Insights are specific buy and sell recommendations for stocks, ETFs, and even options, with stops and price targets included for every trade in my newsletter. If you'd like to try my newsletter risk-free for 30 days, then head over to the front page of TFNN and you'll find Market Insights under Trading Newsletters. I use my years of trading experience to bisect and dissect the market every morning and give my subscribers the most important information they need to know for the day ahead. I even issue afternoon updates for my subscribers whenever warranted with important market action. I'm always scouring the market for the next great trading opportunity. Sign up for your 30-day free trial to my daily newsletter, Market Insights, today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Wow! Go get them, folks.
It's amazing to think that Tom O'Brien started his weekly gold report 17 years ago with the first issue published April 7th, 2002, when gold was trading at under $300 per ounce. Gold peaked at more than $1,900 in 2011, and after spending many years consolidating at lower prices, gold may be poised for its next big run. Tom O'Brien publishes his weekly gold report every Monday morning for subscribers, consisting of coverage of the XAU, HUI, GDX, the dollar, bonds, South African Rand, as well as 25 different mining equities with specific buy-sell recommendations. As of April 1st of this year, the Gold Report currently has 8 active positions with an average unrealized profit of almost 8% for each open trade. New subscribers get a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. For all the details and to start your Gold Report subscription today, visit the front page of TFNN.com. Don't let gold's next big run pass you by. Sign up today. Steve Dahl and Tom O'Brien have just announced a special webinar on June 19th for all subscribers to the TAS Profile Scanner. Steve and Tom will break down the trade matrix, market breadth, heat grid, as well as the three-step process you can use with the TAS Profile Scanner to identify market movers and how to capitalize on that move. For all the details and to get started with the TAS Profile Scanner today, visit the front page of TFNN.com. With a 30-day money-back guarantee, you have nothing to risk. Go sign up today.
TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Welcome back, folks. Dow, it's D9. You get the NASDAQ up 34. S&P's up 16.5. Let's go take a look at the NDX 100, the strength versus the weakness inside the NDX 100. You have... Advanced Micro up 8%. That's a monster number. That's $2.46. Tesla is up 5%, 4.6% at $9.23. You get Broadcom up 3% or $8, and you get NetEase up 2.9% or $7. Taken away from it, BioMarin's down 3.5% or $2.91. You get Vertex Pharmaceutical off 2.9% or $5. You get Lululemon off a 1.5% or $2.56, and you get Mylan Pharmaceutical off 1.4, 25 cents. Inside the Dow Industrials, strength versus the weakness inside the Dow Industrials. Point wise out here, you only have three Dow stocks that are in the negative out here, folks. You have putting positive in. We got Chevron putting 20 positive points, McDonald's 18, Johnson & Johnson's 18, Apple 14. Microsoft 11. Taken away from it, you get Travelers putting 5 negative points, United Health 2, and Nike 1. So you're talking about very small numbers out here. Let's go see what Chevron, CVX, actually is doing. That is the mover inside out here today. And that's caught a bid. There's no doubt. You're up $3. No juice behind it. Now it's coming right into its downdraft from the 12th of April. We're right at this level right now. This is where this gap down. We had gapped from the price point of 126. You gap down to the 122 to 120 area. Monster volume there. We'll see whether it can get any traction and get up and over that level. If we go to ExxonMobil, no action. Chevron's in definitely much better shape than Exxon, that's for sure. Exxon right now is up $1.39. Yeah, I can fill the gap. Get into this $75 level. We're at $74.37 right now. Tesla's got a dead cat bounce going. Excuse me, folks. Tesla right now, that's up $9.14. Now, Tesla looks like, it can bounce a little bit higher. Meaning even get up to that 222. Right now, you're at 205. When you look at Tesla, though, guess what? In 6 months, you've gone from 377, and we hit a low out here on Monday of 176. So you're talking about some serious numbers. Some of the higher volume equities in this market, and I expect, well, let me just see. I expect, you know, you can see the ETF structures. There's going to be a low volume market. Yeah, it's going to be a low volume market. Right now, we're at 441 million inside the NYSE. We take a look at the NASDAQ composite. You're at 1.4. Yeah, so you're gonna come in. You can come in a couple billion in the NASDAQ composite. The NYSE is going to be anemic. Now let's get over and take a look at the S&Ps as we're trading this last hour out here, because I believe it just took out its swing point from the high today. Let's see. Okay, so here we go. So, and what you're going to see here, bring this into one. Okay, cool. Okay, so the real pop happened to be at 10 past 2. And what that pop's all about is that you get reporting out here that they may get a deal, and the specifically that the Taft won't go on tomorrow. Well, here, let me read this fire first. Okay, so this came across at that price point where we had the pop in the market, which is 230. The U.S. is considering delaying President Trump's threatened tariffs on Mexico as talks continue over stemming the flow of undocumented migrants and illegal drugs from Central America, according to people familiar with the matter. Mexico is pushing for more time to negotiate over concerns that the two sides won't be able to reach an agreement on all the steps Mexico would have to take to avert the tariffs, one person said. One official said it's most likely, the most likely outcome is still a 5% tariff goes into effect. The cool thing, folks, is that trading these markets, right, what I've found is this, okay, my take is that we're on an ABC structure on the way down. I've been through so many cycles in the marketplace. There's always news that comes out inside either bear or bull markets, but inside downdrafts, bear markets in general, what does happen is that you get sound bites, news bites on a continual basis that gives you pops. So I can't wait to see how this shakes out, because my take on this is that two different things. My take is, number one, that we're an ABC structure on the way down. Number two, that regardless of what, you know, if you read through this, what you're going to see is that, here, I'll read the next line, because what you have happening here, inside the same article, the market will grab anything that it can grab to go higher. There's no doubt about that. But inside this article, the bottom line is that there is no one inside of this meeting today that has any power whatsoever. Zero. You know, these are basically staffers that are inside there. This thing is on. That's my take on it. I don't want it on, but this thing is on. I think it's going to get worse before it gets better. But we'll see. What I love about it is, like, right here, right now, because what you're going to have happening is that they're going to have one more shot tomorrow. And I'm not talking about the aspect of negotiations. What's going to happen is that the Senate's going to get involved. The House of Representatives is going to get involved. The Senate's more important, of course. You know, they are basically flipped out right now. They're saying they're flipped out. Bottom line, we'll see how this shakes out. Well, we will get out here tomorrow morning again. We're going to get the jobs numbers. That's going to be no doubt an important number, because what you did have, you had the ADP numbers come in a little light. Excuse me, folks. Let's go take a look at some of the big FANG stocks. We'll start with Amazon. We take a look at Amazon out here. Amazon up $13. Same deal. There's no action here. Now, one of the reasons we're looking at these FANGs too, is that these are the ones that took the market much higher, can take the market much lower on a very quick basis. We get over to Google. Google can't move. Google's up $2.92. You get a sideways move. Google is building cars. It's almost into its lows from December 24th. The high of that low is 1,003. We hit 1,033 today. We hit 1,025 on Monday. Microsoft, out of the big FANGs, Microsoft's the only one that it really is strong. Microsoft looks to me like it wants to go hit that high of 131. Right now, at 127.57. We go take a look at Netflix. What you have with Netflix? Netflix right now, not a bad looking chart. This is This is a big sideways consolidation. This thing better hold up, because if it doesn't hold up, you're going all the way back to March of 20. It's the daily, only March of 2019. That it's been on a sideways move. Facebook. We take a look at Facebook. Facebook right now, that's trouble in paradise. Facebook is building cars to get down into this 145. To 123. Right now, Facebook's trading at 169.04. And, you know, the way it's looking to me right now is that you finish today up, you get up a little bit higher tomorrow, give it up on price, start backing down. Next week, you're going to have a downtrend. Dow Industrial's up 190, NASDAQ up 42, S&P's up 19. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
The TAS Profile Scanner is the most revolutionary piece of trading software that you will ever try. Wouldn't you like to approach the markets with confidence? As you begin your trading day, it's likely that you'll be faced with lots of decisions. In order to make the best decision, the first thing you'll need is a strategy that will help you minimize your risks. Whether we're in a bull or bear market, a good strategy is to have the tools needed to help you scan and analyze the markets before you trade. The TAS Profile Scanner instantly scans and filters over 2,500 global financial markets, such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Headed by Steve Dahl, president of TAS Market Profile, the TAS Profile Scanner understands that in today's technological world, the use of top-flight software applications, automated trading algorithms, and technical analysis expertise is essential to successful trading in today's market. Whether you're looking at the trade matrix, the ETF heat grid, the market breadth, the landscape charts, or the many other features of the TAS Profile Scanner, this is a piece of software that will revolutionize how you look at the markets and set up your trades. The team at TAS has even put together a 12-part video series to walk you through every aspect of the TAS Profile Scanner, which you can find directly on the TAS order page at TFNN.com. Sign up now for only $97 a month with a risk-free 30-day trial, so you have nothing to lose and everything to gain. See for yourself how you can harness the full power of the TAS Profile Scanner by visiting the front page of TFNN.com today, and you'll find the TAS Profile Scanner under the Services section. Remember, with a 30-day money-back guarantee, you have nothing to lose. Don't let another day pass you by without trying out this amazing piece of software that will revolutionize how you look at the market and how you place trades. Sign up today. TFNN has put together the best lineup of live content for traders by traders every market day, featuring some of the most knowledgeable and respected minds in the business. TFNN broadcasts 5 days a week live from 9 a.m. until 5 p.m. Eastern Time. We have live programming every market day during market hours. Every morning, Larry Pesavento kicks off the trading day live at 9 a.m. and breaks down the opening bell with Trade What You See. At 10 a.m., Tom and Tommy O'Brien host the Bull Bear Nadex Options Hour, followed at 11 a.m. by the team at TD Ameritrade and Thinkorswim with Fast Market. Basil Chapman hosts the Tiger Technicians Hour at noon, Steve Rhodes at 1 p.m. with the Trader's Edge, Dave White at 2 p.m. with the Power Trading Hour, and Tom O'Brien anchors the daily lineup from 3 till 5 as host of the Tom O'Brien Show. Tune in to TFNN's Tiger TV on your computer or mobile device, and you can always find us streaming on YouTube. TFNN.com, educating investors.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. Dow is up 192. You get the NASDAQ up 41. S&P's up 19. Percentage-wise out here, you have the Dow Industrials trading up 0.7%. NASDAQ, S&P's up 0.5%. So we go over to the oil patch. And inside that oil patch, this thing's going to get really intriguing about how this works out with Mexico. Because what you do have here now is that U.S. oil companies are frantically lobbying congressional allies and the White House against the Mexican tariffs, saying that that it would hike the price of gasoline and strain refiners' reliance on crude from the country. So this is the, you know, I was, you know, we, of course, the oil price has been low. We got plenty of oil. But when you read this out, we are exporting, importing, evidently, oil from Mexico every day as well. And this, the other part of this is going to get really interesting because we're talking about minerals also. So the oil industry's pushback adds pressure on the Republicans, mulling legislation to counter Trump's threatened 5% tariff, which raised the cost. Yeah, so it's a daily deal. Raise the cost of 700. We import right now from Mexico 712,000 barrels of crude a day, along with listen to this one, along with mineral fuels valued at $16 billion. Now mineral fuels. I wonder what mineral fuel is. When I first read that, I thought it was minerals in general. But minerals in general, I guess we'll get TAF too. Oil lobbyists are warning Trump administration officials and congressional allies that widespread economic harm, both for refineries reliant on Mexican crude and U.S. motors hit with higher gasoline prices. In appeals to the White House, lobbyists are stressing that tariffs on Mexican goods would jeopardize the president's other priorities, ensuring American energy dominance and the thriving manufacturing sector. Folks talking to everyone that will listen, said Josh Zive, a senior principal at Bracewell LLP, which represents several refining companies. Refining lobbyists are offering the administration one immediate solution, exempting crude. Yeah, there you go. So everyone's cutting out for themselves, there's no doubt. So here's the exemption, folks. Refining lobbyists are offering the administration one immediate solution, exempting crude from the tariffs if it does go as planned. Otherwise, they warn the added costs will be borne by U.S. oil companies, which will pass it all along to U.S. motorists in the driving season. The way that this gasoline market is set up right now, so let's go look at the gasoline market. Gasoline. Okay, so we take a look at the gasoline market. Right now, we are, this is wholesale now. We're at 172. We hit a low today of 166. This wants a lower price. Okay, so check it out, man. We're down from this high 3 weeks ago of 205 wholesale. We're 172. But if you're watching Tiger TV, folks, what you're going to see is this. Just like the market in general, you've come down with big volume, and you're bouncing with light volume. You have 57,000 contracts. Let's see, hold it. The July XB. I want to make sure I get the active contract. Yeah, it's the active contract. Bottom line is that, you're down on volume. You're bouncing right now 57,000 contracts. That's same as the market. That's setting up another B to C of a potential ABC structure on the way down. You know, so we'll see how that baby shakes out, but there's no doubt that that is going to get some heavy pressure, particularly because what does happen is that you have, of course, Texas, Louisiana. This is what we're talking about, the Gulf of Mexico. You're talking about refining in a big way, and a lot of that, 756,000 comes across the border. As we're speaking right here, let's go take a look at that S&P, because there's no doubt the S&P is getting a bid right now. ESM9, I bet we're getting close to that 285 that I'm looking for. Okay, so the S&Ps are up 24.50. We go back to the SPY. There she comes. That's a beautiful thing. Yeah, so 285.10. That's what I was looking for. The top of that is 286.69. We just hit 285.35. So now we're getting into that area. That's the area, folks, where I suspect we're going to get this turn. That's ice when you break down. When we broke down on the 9th of May, the top of that area is 287. The bottom's 283. You're going into 103 million shares. And if we go take a look at the NDX 100, boy, that's still weak. Interesting, man. Yeah, that's at 159. 177 rather, 84. You know, 178.06 is the number there. So, what I really like to see, folks, I'd really like to see it get up there right now. Because what I suspect is we're going to see happen in the morning is this. You got to remember the jobs number comes out at 8:30. We're going to have plenty of news that's flashing across the screen, you know, probably all night. The jobs number, I suspect, will be probably the spike high of the day. That's how this seems to be shaken out. Let's swap gears here for a second and go over to Bitcoin. Had quite a run. And now just the opposite. The last 6 days, we've just gone from 9,088 to 7,581. And this looks like it very well can get back into this 6,000 level. That's where you get a big gap higher at that 6,000 level. We go to, the Canopy Growth. We'll go to a couple of these pot stocks. So Canopy Growth is up 86 cents today. This is going to be interesting watching this shake out because, you know, these have been in a consolidation for a long period of time, actually going all the way back to January of this year. And it looks to me that, you know, we're basically going to try to back down into this, Canopy looks like it wants to back down to 34. And if that's what you get, this is going to be setting up for a buy because it's this strength here. You know, there's, when we went topside on the 17th. Sorry, folks. No, I see. That is a year ago. Unbelievable. Wow. Time is crazy. Yeah, this is on a weekly. So when we broke out last August, Canopy went from $24. 3 weeks later, it's at $56. Gave it up. Come all the way back down. Tested to $26. Did the test on 15 million shares versus 66. Then what it did, couldn't make it up again. And so now it looks like it's just going to back down into this $28 area. And if that's what you get, that is going to be really intriguing because, of course, what ends up happening in that cannabis business now, you get a lot more numbers that are out there. You have a lot more companies that you can compare. You know, what are you paying for that equity? And what's the growth area going forward, particularly in the aspect that what you do have is that we're going to be approaching legal cannabis up in Canada almost a full year. And that's a big number because you can take a look at Canopy Growth. They're going to do $230 million this year. They expect to do $797 million next year. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
If you are in the CD market and looking for a secure investment, the Tiger First Mortgage Program may work for you. The security for these first mortgages are building lots in the tax opportunity zone in St. Petersburg, Florida. The Tax Act of 2018 set up tax-free zones across the country where you can build and hold for 10 years and pay no tax on the profits, which makes these lots valuable. The investment is anywhere from $30,000 to $75,000. The interest paid is 7% yearly paid on a monthly basis. According to Bankrate.com, the best rate for a four-year CD in the country as of February 20th is 3.1%. A $50,000 investment at a normal four-year CD rate of 3.1% would give you income of $1,550 per year or $6,200 over the four-year period. That same $50,000 investment in the Tiger First Mortgage Program would give you $3,500 per year or $14,000 over the 4 years. Which would you prefer, $6,200 or $14,000 of interest on your investment? If you would like more information about the Tiger First Mortgage Program, you can call me at 877-518-9190. That's 877-518-9190.
The Path of Least Resistance is David White's daily trading newsletter, and if you're looking for active trading ideas, then now's a perfect time for a 30-day free trial to this powerful daily trading advisory service. David uses his years of trading experience to offer his subscribers his trading ideas each morning in his Path of Least Resistance newsletter. Using a combination of equity trades along with options, David keeps his subscribers up to date with all pertinent market information with intraday afternoon updates when warranted. Don't don't miss out on this great chance to get a 30-day free trial to David's daily newsletter, The Path of Least Resistance, with no obligation to pay anything. David has been delivering solid recommendations for his subscribers recently, and if you'd like to see the type of newsletter he delivers every morning, then visit the front page of TFNN, and you'll find The Path of Least Resistance under Trading Newsletters. For all the details and to start your 30-day free trial today, log on to TFNN.com now. Biotech is booming, but for how long? Whether you think the biotech bull has room to run or has run its course, trade LABU or LABD. Direction's daily S&P Biotech 3x bull and bear ETFs. Visit directioninvestments.com/biotech today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back, folks. Dow's up by 222. 228. NASDAQ is up 49. S&P is up 21. Let's go take a look at the financials out here. The XLF. XLF out here, folks, up 16 cents. You are trading 27.21. And the number to keep your eye on here is going to be kind of right where we are. 27.19, 27.21. Oh, this is quiet. Well, it's going to be cool watching this shake out. So, yeah, this is going to be great watching how this closes. So this is going to be really subtle, folks, but this is what you have. This is coming into the same area where I expect the S&P is going to come into. We're just about there right now, by the way. And so this number to watch is that, is it going to be able to hold these two pennies? It's 27.21. You come in at the 41 million as well as 62 million and 36. And right now you're at 30. So Berkshire, let's go take a look at Berkshire. Berkshire hasn't been able to get any juice, and of course that's the largest weighting structure inside there. That's up $1.75 today. That has volume of 2 million shares, and that's going into 4. So I can go a little bit higher. 206. 206.66 would line you up at about that exact same area. We go take a look at some of the auto stocks, because the auto stocks no doubt are going to get slammed on the aspect of the input tax from Mexico. And so we have here, you have GM down 18 cents. You're trading 35.28. And we put this on a weekly. Yeah, it's been in consolidation for a long time. But bottom line is that what you have game here is $30. And right now you're at 35.28. We take a look at, Ciena. Let's go bring up Ciena. This is a blast from the past, like about 20 years ago. So this equity here is a little rocket ship out here today. Where are you, Ciena? There it is. So Ciena is up almost 25%. So Ciena, okay, the way Ciena works, folks, is that they have patents, and they're basically getting paid on patents, okay? They develop market communication network platform software. The low for the year is 23, the high is 45, and this just popped beyond belief today. You know, so this stock opened at 42, trading 45, monster number. Let's see what they had to say. Okay, so they had seen... They beat by 7 cents. So they had seen, come on, let me get that number. Sorry about this, folks. Okay. Maybe that's the one I want. Yeah, good. Okay. So First off, they're seeing 20% annual growth year over year. That's a big number. Their margin, low margin, 15%. It is what it is. Inventories were totaling 359. Their ranges went up pretty dramatically. So they were expecting to do 23 cents. They made 48. Big number. Big number, no doubt. They expected to do a revenue number of $819 million. They made $865. So you can see that is no doubt a very large expansion of revenue. And if we pull this back, yeah, bottom line is that it's trying to get up into this $45 area. You know, if you take a look at this stock... Let me bring this back way far, because this stock, I remember this like in the 90s. Oh, there it is. Oh, my God. This is sick. So listen to this. No wonder I remember it. So 1998, the stock's at $28. Now, this is going to be after redoing reverse splits. So you had $28, and then the stock went up to $1,057, folks, in December of 2000 before the crash. Check that out. That's sick. And then it crashed from $1,057 down to $25. Yep. Man, the euphoria of that market on eyeballs in 1998 to 2000 is pretty crazy. You know, if you were around at that point, people were paying for eyeballs. They were losing money hand over fist. And the analysts, now picture, these are analysts that no doubt, you know, probably went to some of the best schools in the world. Somehow, the bottom line is that it didn't matter whether you made money. And that's where, whether it's Uber or Lyft, I think that it's going to get really intriguing watching how they shake out, because of the amount of money that they actually are telling the market that they're going to lose. I mean, it's a phenomenal amount of money. You know, Uber already got the award for the biggest loss for new public company, first quarter they lost $1 billion. Well, when you look at these numbers, their bottom line is that they're going to lose $5 this year, a share. That's what they're saying. Now, the intriguing thing about the $5 loss, though, with Uber this year, is that they have them front-end loaded. They just lost $2.50, the numbers they came up with last week. They claim they're going to lose another $2.39 in the next quarter. Then they claim they're going to go from that to only losing 80 cents. That, you know... Bottom line, it can happen, no doubt, but that's kind of a miracle number when you can go from 239 to 86 cents in an additional 60 days. Let's say we'll take 90 from, well, actually, we're already in it because, let's see. Yeah, the end of June, this is the end of the second quarter. And then next year, they say they're losing $3. LYFT, we go take a look at Lyft. What you got with Lyft out here? Lyft is trading... 61.33, and number wise here, yeah, oh my God, monster number. So Lyft, first quarter losing $9 a share. Okay, so they haven't even updated this yet, because this is what's going on. They were claiming that they're going to lose $7 for the year, but they lost $9 on the first quarter. And then next year, they're still losing money. So bottom line is that we'll see how those companies actually get in the green. What was pretty cool is that I saw yesterday, you had Uber is going to basically start doing Uber helicopter. They're starting it in Manhattan and a couple other cities, but there's another company up there, Blade, right now, that's been doing it. And I suspect that could work. You know, they're expecting the rides to be a couple hundred bucks. Getting you out of Manhattan into the airports. And guess what, folks? If you go out of Manhattan and you go to JFK or LaGuardia, I've done it hundreds of times, it's $50 by car. You know, 50, you know, so by helicopter, a couple hundred bucks, I can see that going all day long. Real question is going to be how many helicopters do they have? And, you know, are they going to be able to make money at that point? There's five. The article that I was reading is there's five folks per helicopter. And They did a couple test runs, very small test runs, but what has happened is that the, you know, they were full. So that's going to be a decent deal, at least for consumers. Stay right there, folks. Come right back. Dow up 227, NASDAQ up 51, S&P's up 21. Come right back.
I'm certain you are or strive to be one of the best of the best at everything you do in life. It's the most common trait that we tigers and tigresses share. If you're looking to become the best of the best when it comes to managing your money, let me teach you to do what most wealth managers tell you can't be done, which is how to time the markets. I'm Steve Rhodes, author of Mastering Probability, and for the last 12 months, Timer Digest has been tracking my newsletter signals, which have earned me the ranking as their number one market timer in the nation for the S&P 500 for the last 12, 6, and 3 months. Timer Digest also ranks me as the number one market timer for gold as well. The fact is, markets can be timed, and I'll teach you the exact set of tools that I use that has transformed me into one of the best at what I do. Sign up for Mastering Probability today by clicking on the newsletter tab on the homepage of TFNN.com and get immediate access to workshops where I take you step by step how to use an extraordinary set of tools as well as provide great market calls too. Sign up today.
Basil Chapman has a special subscriber webinar coming up Wednesday, June 12th at 5 p.m. called The Tide. In this webinar, Basil will be demonstrating techniques that can help one identify whether the tide is coming in or going out. That is, whether a trend is bullish or bearish in a variety of time frames. And Basil will be speaking specifically to indices, currencies, commodities, interest rates, and key stocks. The technical tools that Basil will be discussing are available on almost all software packages that will be shown in historical context as well as live for current market setups. Identifying the key trend allows one to trade with the tide rather than against it. Subscribers also gain immediate access to 3 archived workshops so you can get started right away when you sign up. For all the details on the opening call and Basil's upcoming subscriber webinar, The Tide, this coming Wednesday, visit the front page of TFNN.com and sign up today.
You know what's cool? Taking something that's good for you. Something specifically formulated to help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Nico, our hunter and gatherer ancestors found all their nutritional requirements for health in their wild environment. But today, our food sources no longer contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients our bodies need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionics, oil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty, and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated folic and humic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They have been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, life cannot exist without them.
That's right, Paige. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning.
Primal Edge, formulated and approved by Nico and Paige of Living a Primal Lifestyle. Buy it today for just $89. Click on the Primal Edge banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
Welcome back, folks. Dow is up 198. You get the NASDAQ up 41. S&P's up 18. We're going to take a look at the volume coming in with 10 minutes left in the marketplace. You get 514 million inside the NYSE. Now, that should pull up to about 850, 900, but I suspect that's going to be a contraction once again. Inside the composite, what do you have with the composite? Right now, you're 1.7. We'll see whether they get 2 billion into that. We go over the SPY. You take a look at the SPY. SPY, we're at 50 million. It's not going to do it. I love it, man. This is crazy. So this is going to be wild watching this shake out, folks, because you have the contraction going on. You're coming into the swing. It's a nice little setup all around. 51 million, we'll see whether they can get 60 million. They should be able to get 60 million into it at the close. 9 million is not a lot coming into that SPY. NDX 100, I suspect, is going to be the same setup. It is. You're 25 million, and maybe they can get 30 million. Well, we did 34 million yesterday. The prior day did 47, and the SPY, I mean, the Qs are coming at the $67 million. And that is a classic, meaning that you come down in volume, you go up with lighter volume, you get a good bounce going. Let's go take a look at the trend out here, and let's see how folks were running into this market. Trends at 0.81, so what that is saying also is that you had them basically buying somewhat of the same stocks. The tick is going to be the most important part out here, and we take a look at this tick, and what you're going to see inside, there it goes again. I love it. You don't, it's minus, it's a plus 1,400, 1,485. Yeah, that doesn't happen. So you get, you're coming, so all this week, we got a plus 1,519 on Monday. Yeah, on Tuesday, you get a plus 13. Yesterday, you get a plus 11. That's no big deal. Today is a big deal, though. Today, you get a plus 1,447 and 1,485. Stay right there, folks. We're going to be coming back with some numbers after the close. Dow Industrials trading up 182. NASDAQ up 35. S&P's up 16. Come right back.
Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he's watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date active trading information that will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters.
David White's newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and the Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your 2-week free trial to the Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today.
If you haven't checked out the newsletters page of TFNN.com, what are you waiting for? All of the TFNN newsletters are informative, up-to-date, affordable, and a must-have for every trader looking to gain a competitive informational edge in today's markets. TFNN newsletters cover every aspect of the markets to offer you the very latest in market news. Plus, new subscribers get to test drive our newsletters risk-free for 30 days. From all aspects of the markets, including stocks, bonds, metals, commodities, and tech, there's a newsletter to fit your needs exclusively from TFNN. Stay informed each day you trade and get that competitive edge that will help you stay ahead of the game. Visit our newsletters page by going to TFNN.com and click the newsletters button near the top of the page. TFNN.com, educating investors.
This is TFNN, the Tiger Financial News Network. TFNN, headline news update.
Welcome, folks. We had the Dow Industrials finish up 188. You had the NASDAQ up 40, S&P's up 18. Percentage-wise, folks, you had the NASDAQ up 5/10 of 1%, S&P's Dow up 7/10 of 1%. Volume's going to be light out here. This number I'll give you right now, they'll throw a little more into it. They get another 10 minutes to throw something into it. Right now, we have 591 million inside the NYSE. When you take a look at the composite is going to be a closer number, 1.9 billion. The composite gets much closer than the NYSE because the NYSE, they have another 10 minutes to throw some real juice into it. Gold contract up $4.20, trading at $13.37 an ounce. You had silver up 6 cents, $14.85 an ounce. Both gold and silver going after their February highs. Light sweet crude up $1.60, trading $53.29 a barrel. Notes and bonds. You get the 10-year note down 3 ticks, 126.28. 30-year bond up 2 at 153.15. They both, folks, are building cars for higher price. King dollar, bottom line, got into a lower price and has the volume once again on the downside. We take a look at this. What you're going to see is good old King dollar has been building cars to get into lower price. Now, this is the first time in a long period of time that we've had 4 separate days down with volume. We actually have sellers inside of the dollar index right now. We get the jobs numbers coming out at 8:30 tomorrow morning. I expect what we're going to see out here is that you're going to continue with volatility in this market. If we go over to the S&P, bottom line looks to me like the S&P setting up a nice B to C of an ABC structure on the way down. You certainly got the contraction of volume. Yesterday you did 71 million, right now you're at 64. The prior day we did 77, yesterday you did 71, today you did 64. NDX 100, same setup inside the NDX. NDX out here. Really anemic. And it's important to pay attention to the NDX, folks, because the NDX is what took us off the highs also. First brought us up, then took us off. Fast, furious, all of the above. The NDX out here, 3 Qs today, we did 29 million. Yesterday was 34. The prior day was 47. And you're going into 67. 177.61. That's where we're at right now. Stay right there, folks. We get some numbers coming out after the close. Including Beyond Meat. This is going to be their first numbers out as a public company, and they got a $6 billion market cap right now, and they're only expecting to take in $200 million for the full year. Coming right back, folks.
TFNN has put together the best lineup of live content for traders by traders every market day, featuring some of the most knowledgeable and respected minds in the business. TFNN broadcasts 5 days a week live from 9 a.m. until 5 p.m. Eastern Time. We have live programming every market day during market hours. Every morning, Larry Pesavento kicks off the trading day live at 9 a.m. and breaks down the opening bell with Trade What You See. At 10 a.m., Tom and Tommy O'Brien host the Bull Bear Nadex Options Hour, followed at 11 a.m. by the team at TD Ameritrade and Thinkorswim with Fast Market. Basil Chapman hosts the Tiger Technicians Hour at noon, Steve Rhodes at 1 p.m. with the Trader's Edge, Dave White at 2 p.m. with the Power Trading Hour, and Tom O'Brien anchors the daily lineup from 3 till 5 as host of the Tom O'Brien Show. Tune in to TFNN's Tiger TV on your computer or mobile device, and you can always find us streaming on YouTube. TFNN.com, educating investors.
If you're in the CD market and looking for a secure investment, the Tiger First Mortgage Program may work for you. The security for these first mortgages are building lots in the tax opportunity zone in St. Petersburg, Florida. The Tax Act of 2018 set up tax-free zones across the country where you can build and hold for 10 years and pay no tax on the profits, which makes these lots valuable. The investment is anywhere from $30,000 to $75,000. The interest paid is 7% yearly, paid on a monthly basis. According to Bankrate.com, the best rate for a four-year CD in the country as of February 20th is 3.1%. A $50,000 investment at a normal four-year CD rate of 3.1% would give you income of $1,550 per year or $6,200 over the four-year period. That same $50,000 investment in the Tiger First Mortgage Program would give you $3,500 per year or $14,000 over the 4 years. Which would you prefer, $6,200 or $14,000 of interest on your investment? If you'd like more information about the Tiger First Mortgage Program, you can call me at 877-518-9190. That's 877-518-9190.
The Path of Least Resistance is David White's daily trading newsletter, and if you're looking for active trading ideas, then now's a perfect time for a 30-day free trial to this powerful daily trading advisory service. David uses his years of trading experience to offer his subscribers his trading ideas each morning in his Path of Least Resistance newsletter. Using a combination of equity trades along with options, David keeps his subscribers up to date with all pertinent market information with intraday afternoon updates when warranted. Don't miss out on this great chance to get a 30-day free trial to David's daily newsletter, The Path of Least Resistance, with no obligation to pay anything. David has been delivering solid recommendations for his subscribers recently, and if you'd like to see the type of newsletter he delivers every morning, then visit the front page of TFNN, and you'll find The Path of Least Resistance under Trading Newsletters. For all the details and to start your 30-day free trial today, log on to TFNN.com now.
The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Let's go to our man Jim in Palm Harbor. Hey, what's going on, brother?
Hey, how you guys doing today?
Doing great, man. How you been?
Oh, great. I really appreciate you and Tommy. Great job, great work, and I really appreciate it. I watch you every day.
Well, thank you so much. We appreciate you growling and prowling with us out here, man. Let's go to Sylvia in Tampa. Hey, Sylvia, how you doing?
Hey, Tom. Good morning. Thank you so much for taking my call. I want to tell you thank you so much for the advice you gave me on dust yesterday. I exited when you told me, and I made a healthy profit for a very short period. So thank you.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night, folks. Don't make assumptions. Learn to ask questions. It is always better to ask questions than to make assumptions. Have the courage to ask questions until you're as clear as you can be. Once you hear the answer to the question, you won't have to make the assumption because you'll know the truth. That's if they tell you the truth, right? Well done. Market wise, let's take a look at it out here. We had the Dow Industrials finish up 181. You had the NASDAQ up 40, S&P's up 17.5. Percentage-wise out here, folks, what that gives you is 5/10 gain in the NASDAQ, 7/10 in the NDX1, in the composite. No, I'm sorry. 7/10 in the S&P as well as the Dow Industrials. Gold contract up $4.60, trading at $13.38 an ounce. We had silver up 6 cents. $14.86 an ounce. Now, both gold and silver, the broken top side this week. Silver finally followed it up. What they're doing out here today, you're pushing into the swing point. You have volume as you're pushing into that swing point. Oil up $1.50, trading $53.18. You got notes and bonds. 10-year note down 3 ticks, 126.28. 30-year bond up 4 at 153.17. Both notes and bonds continue to want higher price, lower yield. We have the 10-year yielding out here right now, folks, at 2.1. And 2.07 was the low that was established out here this week. King dollar down 241 ticks, trading 97.010. What King dollar has done is this. Last 4 days, you've gone to lower prices. You have volume behind the move. King dollar looks to me like it wants to get down to the 94 level. That's the lower end of this consolidation that we've been in since October of last year. The euro is at 112 to one U.S. dollar. The yen is at 108.5. And the pound is at 126 to one U.S. dollar. Let's go over to Beyond Meat. That just come out with numbers. Now, this is the first time as a public company they've come out with their numbers. Beyond Meat closed out here today at $99.50 at just about a $6 billion market cap. So monster number out here, no doubt. Beyond Meat went public. Let's see. This is quite a profitable buy. Yeah, went public on May 1st at $25 We take a look at this chart, and what you're going to see, you didn't have a chance to buy it, of course, on the first. It opened on the second at, let's see, we opened at 46, you went to 45, you closed at 65, and the stock never looks back. Right now, the stock is trading at $105, so we closed at 99.50. It was down 310. You're trading $105, and number-wise goes like this. They had revenue. They had an expectation of revenue of 205 million. Oh, that's for the year. They still expect that. They expected to make 205 million gross for the year. Now they're expecting to make 210. Their revenue was for this quarter 40 million. Their expectation was 38 million. The loss was 95 cents. And if you want to just see something that's really pretty bizarre, I was just doing the numbers on this. So check out, bottom line, it's up another $5. We'll see whether that shakes out. But I want to show you something just in general. So you have a market cap of $5.9 billion. They're still telling you flat out that, guess what, that we have $205 million. Now they're saying they're going to make $210 million for the year. They're going to lose 41 cents. They're going to lose next year also. But now watch this. So that's $205 million gross, and they lose 41 cents, and they have, so they're losing 95, 4, 8, 12. They're losing about 16 million a year, at least. Maybe more than that. Oh, no, they're definitely losing more than that. Oh, my God. Hold on. No. Percentage of flat. I was looking at the shot percentage. They're losing. They just lost 59 million this quarter. Yeah, they're 59, 60, 120, like 240 million, right? No, they can't lose that much. Bottom line, they lost 95 cents. So this quarter, they lost that type of money, meaning almost 50 million. Now, watch this. Tyson, T-Y-S-O-N. If you go to these, what you have to do when you're looking at some of these companies, folks, particularly, someone that's coming in the space, there's no doubt you can just go, you can go to another large company that's in the space to see, okay, how does this work? Okay, so if I bring up Tyson, which, of course, is a monster in the meat business. Now, they're beyond meat, but the bottom line is that what they're saying is that they're saying that people are going to buy this in substitute of meat and or vegetarians in general. So Beyond Meat has a $6 billion market cap. Now, this has a $29 billion market cap, but watch the numbers on this. This is where it's hard to wrap your head around how Beyond Meat could have a market cap of $6 billion. Tyson takes in $43 billion a year, a billion, versus $210 million. They bring to their bottom line $6 a share to the bottom line, and they have 300 million shares. So it says 1.8 billion. 1.8 billion in profit. So the bottom line is that we'll see, how this shakes out. In the last hour, what I had just been bringing up is the aspect of we're looking back to Ciena, and Ciena was an equity in the 90s that was very hot. Went from $28 up to 1,000 and crashed to 25. Got a good bid out here today, trading 45. But we're just talking about the aspect of what equities are actually worth versus what people are actually paying for them, okay? So we're talking about big numbers. That they're actually paying for the right to own something that you're actually losing money on, but they're banking on the aspect that the growth potential will be so large that the growth potential will kick in as to how they are basically losing money. When we take a look at this, they are expecting their growth potential, to really, I guess it's going to be good. I mean, they're $205 million this year. Now they're at $210. They're expecting $335 next year. So that's no doubt. That's a decent way. But for the amount of money that they're losing and for the market cap of that versus a established meat company, it's pretty intense. Stay right there, folks. Come right back. We'll be right back.
folks, Tom O'Brien here. If you'd like to get my daily newsletter, Market Insights, then now is a great time to sign up for a 30-day free trial. Every morning by 9:30, I send out my morning letter to subscribers with market commentary on a variety of markets, currencies, and commodities to keep investors up to date on the day's trading action. Included in Market Insights are specific buy and sell recommendations for stocks, ETFs, and even options, with stops and price targets included for every trade in my newsletter. If you'd like to try my newsletter risk-free for 30 days, then head over to the front page of TFNN and you'll find Market Insights under Trading Newsletters. I use my years of trading experience to bisect and dissect the market every morning and give my subscribers the most important information they need to know for the day ahead. I even issue afternoon updates for my subscribers whenever warranted with important market action. I'm always scouring the market for the next great trading opportunity. Sign up for your 30-day free trial to my daily newsletter, Market Insights, today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Wow! Go get them, folks.
It's amazing to think that Tom O'Brien started his weekly gold report 17 years ago with the first issue published April 7th, 2002, when gold was trading at under $300 per ounce. Gold peaked at more than $1,900 in 2011, and after spending many years consolidating at lower prices, gold may be poised for its next big run. Tom O'Brien publishes his weekly gold report every Monday morning for subscribers, consisting of coverage of the XAU, HUI, GDX, the dollar, bonds, South African Rand, as well as 25 different mining equities with specific buy-sell recommendations. As of April 1st of this year, the Gold Report currently has 8 active positions with an average unrealized profit of almost 8% for each open trade. New subscribers get a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. For all the details and to start your Gold Report subscription today, visit the front page of TFNN.com. Don't let gold's next big run pass you by. Sign up today. Steve Dahl and Tom O'Brien have just announced a special webinar on June 19th for all subscribers to the TAS Profile Scanner. Steve and Tom will break down the trade matrix, market breadth, heat grid, as well as the three-step process you can use with the TAS Profile Scanner to identify market movers and how to capitalize on that move. For all the details and to get started with the TAS Profile Scanner today, visit the front page of TFNN.com. With a 30-day money-back guarantee, you have nothing to risk. Go sign up today.
TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Welcome back, folks. Dow up 181. NASDAQ up 40. S&P's up 17.5. Let's go take a look at the volume inside the NYSE. Volume 825. So you get a contraction once again, as we did yesterday, and inside the NASDAQ composite, $2 billion. Bottom line, you get the contractions everywhere, folks. Let's go to the IWM and take a look at it. So this is setting up pretty cool. Coming into the IWM, did a 20 million sideways move, 39 cents down. The Qs did, 29 million. Bottom line is that yesterday you did 34, the prior day you did 42, and you're going into 67. So this baby is set up for basically testing the swing area here from the 23rd of May. That's what I expect we're going to see more than likely right either before the jobs number comes out inside the futures market or an initial spike in the marketplace, meaning at the open. Let's go take a look at, I think this is documents.com, DocuSign, yeah. So DocuSign, this has a low of the year, of the last 12 months, that is, of $35. The high is $68. This closed at $54.74. And this is trading at $46, so that's quite a hit. And this is... boy, you can learn a lot from this stock, too, technically, when you take a look at this. So When we take a look at this, what you're going to see is that you got a downdraft coming from the first high that was established on March 15th. You got a sell down on, what was that, last week? That was last Friday. They sold the baby down, and now what you got, you have a decisive break. So let's see what they're having to say. Okay, so their revenue is $214 million. Their loss was 27 cents. Going forward, they expected to take in $219 million. They're saying they're going to take in $218 to $222. For the year, they had seen revenue of $910 million to $915. Now they're going to see $917 to $922. That's higher, but the market's not believing it right now. So if we do take a look at this, you're going to see this is quite a break downtown. $45, so you're down $9. We take this. Oh, yeah. Yeah, this is going right back to, you're going to see how this is laid out. Wow. So this is laid out. This had been a lot higher in 2018. You were up at the $68. You came all the way down into the price point of $35. You did a nice counter trend bounce up to $59. And bottom line is that now you blew apart. Big number on the way down. No doubt about that. What's intriguing, I want to see how much the revenue number is here. Okay, so the revenue is 214. What's interesting about this, folks, is this, is that I sign a lot of these documents like this, but what has happened in the past year, like if I go back 5 years, right, because in the real estate business, that's what you're signing always these kind of forms like this, like, and they're really convenient. But if I go back the last 5 or 6 years, even to a couple years ago, that's all they had out there was DocuForm. Not that they all that had out there, I'd say that that's all that I seen out there, let's put it that way. Then all of a sudden, what ended up happening about 18 months ago, you start seeing other forms coming from attorneys, coming from, basically legal people signing that wasn't DocuForm. So they're getting competition. And I'm going to pay more attention to that now tomorrow morning, exactly what the companies are. Pull a few of them up and see. In fact, I'm going to ask some of those folks, what is the cost? Because what ends up happening when you're on the other side of that, you don't have to pay a cost for that. That is how it works. But someone's paying the cost for that, meaning the folks that are putting the documents together, sending them over to you. So we'll see how that shakes out. But I expect that what you're going to see out here is that that the competition is the deal that is, bottom line, hitting some of these companies. Hitting that company in particular. We take a look at some of the higher volume equities out here, and this was a low volume market out here today. We had Advanced Micro. Let's go to ADM first. Okay, this is a little rocket ship out here today. Now, this has been a highly volatile stock, there's no doubt. And it broke topside. So this broke topside, and if you want to see that, this always had that high spike volume going all the way back to the April 3rd, was going sideways. This is a classic, too, to see. Was pushing with volume again week and a half ago. Was pushing with volume yesterday. Yeah, this is pretty cool, man. And so it looks like we got an ABC structure up here. Let me pull this back a bit. On the weekly, yeah, you do. So it's not a big one, but still a decent one. 21, well, it is pretty big. It actually is big for, it's huge for $30 stock. 21, 29, you're talking about $8. That gets you 34. And the last high out here, oh, there it is. It's going after its high. So check this out. This one's going to be a classic, folks, because you're going after the high of 2018, September of 2018. That high has volume of 34. You broke this high here today. That's where it wants to go. So news-wise, let's see what that was all about. Okay, so that was, they raised it at Morgan Stanley. They see a period of substantial profits. That's what that was pushed on today. Some of the other higher volume equities out here, you had at home. We'll come back to that. That got more than cut in half. That was down $10. It's only $7.50 stock. When I show you how they basically went out to the public and got big money, it's pretty amazing. Stitch Fix, they came out with numbers last night. That's up $3.47, trading $27. You had Microsoft up $2 at $127. Tesla was up $9.36 at $205. That's a pretty good dead cat bounce. You had Ciena was up $9.63, $45.49. And let's go over to, where is that? That's at home. This is a disaster, folks. So check this out. So I haven't seen one of these stores. You know, I'm not quite sure where they are. But the bottom line is that they own, operate home decor stores. Company offers furniture, home furnishings, all of the above. They're out of Texas, Plano, Texas. The low, of course, is today's low. This company went public about a year ago, I believe. Yeah, March of last year. So they went public at $30 a share. Now watch what they did. Then they had a secondary less than 90 days later at $37 a share. They sold another 8 million shares. Then they went public another days later. No, not public. They had a secondary less than 90 days later. They had a third issue of equities less than 90 days at 33. They got monster money, folks. They pushed out 24 million shares at an average price of about $34. You're trading $7.50. They got big problems. Coming right back.
The TAS Profile Scanner is the most revolutionary piece of trading software that you will ever try. Wouldn't you like to approach the markets with confidence? As you begin your trading day, it's likely that you'll be faced with lots of decisions. In order to make the best decision, the first thing you'll need is a strategy that will help you minimize your risks. Whether we're in a bull or bear market, a good strategy is to have the tools needed to help you scan and analyze the markets before you trade. The TAS scanner instantly scans and filters over 2,500 global financial markets, such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Headed by Steve Dahl, president of TAS Market Profile, the TAS Profile Scanner understands that in today's technological world, the use of top-flight software applications, automated trading algorithms, and technical analysis expertise is essential to successful trading in today's market. Whether you're looking at the trade matrix, the ETF heat grid, the market breadth, the landscape charts, or the many other features of the TAS Profile Scanner, this is a piece of software that will revolutionize how you look at the markets and set up your trades. The team at TAS has even put together a 12-part video series to walk you through every aspect of the TAS Profile Scanner, which you can find directly on the TAS order page at TFNN.com. Sign up now for only $97 a month with a risk-free 30-day trial so you have nothing to lose and everything to gain. See for yourself how you can harness the full power of the TAS Profile Scanner by visiting the front page of TFNN.com today, and you'll find the TAS Profile Scanner under the Services section. Remember, with a 30-day money-back guarantee, you have nothing to lose. Don't let another day pass you by without trying out this amazing piece of software that will revolutionize how you look at the market and how you place trades. Sign up today. TFNN has put together the best lineup of live content for traders by traders every market day, featuring some of the most knowledgeable and respected minds in the business. TFNN broadcasts 5 days a week live from 9 a.m. until 5 p.m. Eastern Time. We have live programming every market day during market hours. Every morning, Larry Pesavento kicks off the trading day live at 9 a.m. and breaks down the opening bell with Trade What You See. At 10 a.m., Tom and Tommy O'Brien host the Bull Bear Nadex Options Hour, followed at 11 a.m. by the team at TD Ameritrade and Thinkorswim with Fast Market. Basil Chapman hosts the Tiger Technicians Hour at noon, Steve Rhodes at 1 p.m. with the Trader's Edge, Dave White at 2 p.m. with the Power Trading Hour, and Tom O'Brien anchors the daily lineup from 3 till 5 as host of the Tom O'Brien Show. Tune in to TFNN's Tiger TV on your computer or mobile device, and you can always find us streaming on YouTube. TFNN.com, educating investors.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. And let's go over and take a look at this Beyond Meat again, because what you have here, folks, is that this is going to be some heavy-duty suffering inside the shot positions in this market for Beyond Beef. Beyond Meat, they closed at $99. This is trading up 16% right now. Even 17%. It's $117.49 right now. And when you do take a look at this, what you're going to see, you know, this number has been going up in a big way. Right now, you have over one of every three shares are in a short position. So that's going to basically do some hurting in this marketplace tonight. And you can see, you know, if you do go short equities, folks, bottom line is that you really got to watch what that percentage of the float is. I don't like to deal with anything that's basically over 8%. Because you got to remember something, that all you have to do is get some kind of expansion going forward, and any of the even larger traders, they know, okay, listen, we got it going. You only need one of every three shares have to be brought back, and that doesn't even basically, that's covering a position. And they're going to force the cover on the position. That's how this is shaken out. Because what we will see out here tomorrow, if this is up 17%, bottom line is that they could force that up 40%. And then the thing collapses. But the bottom line is that is one very large number, as those babies surge. Let's go see who are some of the big players inside of this. So I'm bringing up the 13F. Oh, I see. So you got one of the, Perkins, Kleiner Perkins, which is a big firm with equity capital. I suspect they still own 13% of it. You really don't see any other funds in this thing just yet, at least. And it's probably just too new that, it is. Yeah, it's definitely too new to see what's going on. That being said, let's go back over to At Home, because this is a beating that funds are definitely taking. So let's go take a look at who the largest owners are here. And, okay, so you don't see this type of beating too often, folks, that a stock gets cut more than in half. Okay, so American Capital, or Capital Group, that's, they're out in California. Vanguard, that's going to be just in an ETF. Well, Fidelity's going to take a hit. They still kept buying in the March quarter, too. They own 5.4% of it. BlackRock's going to be an ETF. Okay, so those are some of the buyers that are going to be. You get AEA Investors LP is the biggest owner. That's 16.5%, and then Star Investment is 9%. I wouldn't doubt if this is just. Let's see. I'll pull this up. If this is who took them public, though, let's see. Investor profile. Yeah, so this would be. This is a private equity deal. That's what that is, no doubt. So that is the buyers. Now, let's see if anyone actually lucked out and got out of that equity. So here you go. Oh, look at this. Can you imagine how happy these people are? So Owl Creek Asset Management, they sold. Now, this is as of March 31st. They sold all their stock, 1.2 million. Lord Abbott also sold all their stock. You had Victory Capital sell half of it. Copper Rock Capital, they sold all of it. This is right in March, too, by the way. Let's see. Wells Fargo, they sold half their position. Waddell Reed sold a quarter of a position. Redwood sold all of it, $350,000. Goldman sold half their position. Federated Investments sold everything. Oh, actually, and Federated, too. Watch this. If this is pretty cool, if you're watching this. So Federated had one, two, three. They had it in four different funds, and they sold out of each particular fund. Well, this is going to be a smart move, too. So watch this. Putnam did the same thing. Putnam Investments also did the same thing. You get a lot of sellers in here, man. American Express, they sold out. Now we're getting down to about 69,000 shares. So watch this for a second. I'm just going to show you this. So that sell, when we're looking at those sells, that is the January, February, March time frame. Okay? So let's just take this and, yeah, so. Yeah, so they were selling at approximately, now what will end up happening here, now this is where you see the deal though, that you could actually sell and you're still a winner even though you lost. Because I suspect what you have here is this. This was below the IPO price that they were selling. They were selling anywhere from $15 to $25. That's how this thing was set up. But guess what? You're at $7 now. So that's when, you know, that whole deal about cutting your losses is so important, because you never know. This is one of the problems, folks. You never know when an equity is going to get cut just like that. Now, that, I would say, is very unusual that it's so dramatic. But guess what? We're in the air right now. I can't picture why, number one, you'd open a concrete store selling home goods. I mean, really? You're going to go against Restoration Hardware? Well, let's go look at Restoration Hardware for a second. I think it's RH, isn't it? Let's see. Yeah, so Restoration Hardware, lows 84, the high's 164, you're trading at 88. This is, you know, one of the premier companies out here. They're taking $2.5 billion. They're growing by 5%. And when you look at the chart, guess what? You know, these are tough business. You're down from 164. I have a hard time comprehending per square foot how they actually even pay the rent for the size of the stores that they have and then make money on top of it. I mean, you know, they have beautiful stuff. There's no doubt. And this company makes money. I mean, they make $8.54 a share. So They're making the money. There's no doubt about that. But guess what? You're competing what you're really competing with. You're competing, no doubt, with the aspect of online merchandise delivered to your door, almost the exact same type of merchandise. You know, big. It's that is a big problem to compete with. You get Guess. Guess, which is the clothing designer, that closed at $15.68. Today, that is trading at $15.90. This is basically an all-time low to Guess. This is no doubt the problem child also. This equity here, we bring this back. And, you know, when you think about retail, you bring that back $53.2008. That thing, bottom line, not much juice behind it. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
Biotech is booming, but for how long? Whether you think the biotech bull has room to run or has run its course, trade LABU or LABD. Direction's daily S&P Biotech 3x bull and bear ETFs. Visit directioninvestments.com/biotech today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Basil Chapman has a special subscriber webinar coming up Wednesday, June 12th at 5 p.m. called The Tide. In this webinar, Basil will be demonstrating techniques that can help one identify whether the tide is coming in or going out. That is, whether a trend is bullish or bearish in a variety of time frames. And Basil will be speaking specifically to indices, currencies, commodities, interest rates, and key stocks. The technical tools that Basil will be discussing are available on almost all software packages that will be shown in historical context as well as live for current market setups. Identifying the key trend allows one to trade with the tide rather than against it. Subscribers also gain immediate access to 3 archived workshops so you can get started right away when you sign up. For all the details on the opening call and Basil's upcoming subscriber webinar, The Tide, this coming Wednesday, visit the front page of TFNN.com and sign up today.
I'm certain you are or strive to be one of the best of the best at everything you do in life. It's the most common trait that we tigers and tigresses share. If you're looking to become the best of the best when it comes to managing your money, let me teach you to do what most wealth managers tell you can't be done, which is how to time the markets. I'm Steve Rhodes, author of Mastering Probability, and for the last 12 months, Timer Digest has been tracking my newsletter signals, which have earned me the ranking as their number one market timer in the nation for the S&P 500 for the last 12, 6, and 3 months. Timer Digest also ranks me as the number one market timer for gold as well. The fact is, markets can be timed, and I'll teach you the exact set of tools that I use that has transformed me into one of the best at what I do. Sign up for Mastering Probability today by clicking on the newsletter tab on the homepage of TFNN.com and get immediate access to workshops where I take you step by step how to use an extraordinary set of tools as well as provide great market calls too. Sign up today.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back, folks. Dow finished up trading. Let's see, we're up 181. NASDAQ up 40, S&P's up 12. And what you'll see out here, folks, is that we were talking about the tariffs at 2 o'clock this afternoon. They had the story come out saying that they thought a couple unidentified White House staffers saying that they're going to give more time. Bottom line, the White House just came out and said, we're on for putting these tariffs in place. And what you'll see when the futures open back up, you'll see those open down, because what we have right now, the SPY is still trading. The SPY was up $1.84. Right now, it's down 60 cents. From that level, if we go take a look at the Qs closed at 177.61. You're at 177.13. Bottom line, it's hard to basically trade off of news in general. And guess what? We're going to be having a lot of news events come at you. Thank you. We just opened back up. We did open back up. So you got the ESM 9s. We are trading. That's not that bad, actually. You know what's interesting here? Yeah, I see. We're at 28.53. So you're down, you're down 13 points from the high. But what has happened here, this is interesting. What's actually happened is that they're nailing the SPY and the Qs heavier than they're actually handling the futures right now. We'll see where it shakes out. What does happen in particular, we were talking about the last hour, is that when you have markets like this, folks, something always seems to come in between it. Boosting the market up. You get the spike, then you give it up in spades. The big number tomorrow morning is going to be the jobs number. There's no two ways about that. The way that the bond market is trading, bonds continue to want higher price. And that is the market, I would say, that you really want to wrap your head around, folks. The reason is this, is that picture for the last even 10 years, right? If you're a fundamentalist, it's really hard, and believe me, in the bond market as well in the gold market, I know both of them upside down technically and fundamentally, and it's really hard to wrap your head around, like, why wouldn't the interest rate structure be higher? In particular, we hit a heavy low, no doubt, in the middle of the Depression, 2007, 2008. you go, you can picture that you get a 0-10 year at that point. That totally makes sense. A bank on bank rate, discount rate. Then you go, you start coming up, you're coming up, you know, you get the cities coming back, you get cash coming back, you get all of the above coming back. And it's like, okay, well, it would make sense that, you know, rates could keep going. Well, the bond market wasn't saying that. So the bond market has been continued to say that rates are coming down, and they've forced the rates down, you know. And it just seems that, like, how did the bond market understand that Trump was going to be the tariff man and put taxes on all of us for everything? You know, it's just the opposite of what you think is going to happen. You know, bottom line is that first you had the biggest tax cut, corporate tax cut in a long period of time. Well, guess what? He gives the companies, they get the tax cut. Guess what? We get the tax raise. That's going to be the next number out of here, folks. What you're going to see, you know, bottom line is that we're the ones that are paying the tax and all this. You know, you get the banger coming out of China, and then, you know, let's say 5% starts on Monday. They already have the time frame going that it's going to be 25% by October, and I don't think we're going to see any difference. What we have out here right now is that we are at $2.11, 2.1 in the 10-year. 1.71 is the next number. And I suspect we're going to get there. You get to 1.71, that's going to put the 30-year at about 3.5, 3.65. That's a great 30-year. And guess what? If we don't hold that, then you're going to all-time lows, which is 131. You know, in the world right now, which is still important to wrap your head around, is that our 10-year is 2.1. And, you know, whether it's Italy is 2.4, Italy's broke. You get Germany is negative. So in Germany, it's 0.2% that you are paying the government for them to borrow money off of you. That's a pretty hard deal to wrap your head around. In France, they're willing to pay you 0.1%. The Netherlands is just about, no, that's in a negative rate also. So you get the gist of it. Our rates, in the context of world rates, are still heavy. They're still up there. That's the bottom line. We go take a look at the gold market, what you can expect out here when these jobs numbers come out tomorrow morning. I expect we're going to see gold go topside once again. What does happen, folks, is that when gold has had a decent week and you're coming into a Friday, most times what you're going to see is a nice expansion up, because what happens is that when the momentum's with you inside the metals market, there's less selling shot of the metals between Friday afternoon and Monday, because what happens is that you can't close the position. That's the problem. When we have an expansion like we have right now on the upside, most times you're going to see that go higher. When we have a week inside the gold market that you've been down, Fridays can be a disaster, because what ends up happening is that the bears inside the metals market, they're going to force the issue, they're going to trash it, and bottom line is that it can be a problem child. So it's really going to be cool watching this shake out tomorrow morning, because we're right next to the swing high right now of the 1361 that was established out here on the 20th of February. You know, yesterday we hit the 1348 mark. We go take a look at King Dollar. I expect what you're going to see, you're going to see some downward pressure inside King Dollar. What King Dollar has been doing, it's been running to the downside. This is the first time since last October, folks, that we've actually got 4 days of volume to the downside and you come down on price. You know, what has happened since last October, every time that we went to highs, volume died in the vine. Every time you pull back, you had 1 day of pullback in volume, then all of a sudden, no more sellers. Differential right now out here. And the differential in the marketplace, no doubt, is that the market itself, I would say, is trying to figure out, as all of us are, as to what are going to be the ramifications that we have a 25% tax tariff coming from China, an additional 5% starting Monday from Mexico, going up to 25% until October. The market, you know, doesn't like uncertainty, folks. Yeah, I'm sure you've heard that a million times. The uncertainty on the Mexico deal is a little bit higher, because I suspect what we have right now is that you're going to have analysts, and they better be working all weekend long to figure out what companies are going to get hit the most, because those are the companies, folks, that they're following, that they're going to have to come up with some kind of a material paper that what is that going to cost that company and what it's going to cost the top line as well as the bottom line. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date, active trading information that will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters.
David White's newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and The Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your 2-week free trial to the Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today.
TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that we'll even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
Welcome back, folks. Dow finished up by 180. Had the Nasdaq up 40. S&P's up 10. And as I said a little bit earlier, whether it's the 3 o'clock or 4 o'clock hour, it looks to me, folks, that we have a B to C of an ABC structure down has just about set up. And the SPY out here today, I was looking for this 285.10. We got to 285.55. You closed at 284.80. And right now, that SPY is trading out at 284.09. So you're down 70 cents after the close. And what that was all about is that the White House come out and then said the bottom line is that these tariffs are coming down the pike. And as I said a little bit earlier, they had until tomorrow. But the bottom line is that these tariffs are going on. Beyond Meat, yeah, Beyond Meat, this is a serious number. It's up 16% after the close. They closed at $99.50. That's trading at $116.30. And, you know, this is a shot squeeze in a huge way, too, folks. You have 34% of the equities are in a shot position. They took in the revenue that they said they were going to take in. In fact, they think they're going to take in a little bit more. They're losing money hand over fist. What they did say in there, though, is that that they have doubled their manufacturing capacity. And bottom line, we'll see whether they can get something done. You know, I took this equity, and you take a look at it as what they take in versus Tyson, and it's hard to really comprehend. You know, this has a $6 billion market cap. They take in $205 million, right? Well, when you take a look at Tyson, Tyson Foods, okay, has a $29 million market cap. But guess what they take in, folks? Okay, this is pretty intense, man. They take in $43 billion, a billion with a B. They make $1.5 billion. Pretty amazing. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. And whatever you want in life, folks, visualize it just like a motion picture. Step into it, take ownership of it, and fly with it. Everything you need is right inside you. You might as well have a blast with it, folks. We look forward to speaking to you right back here tomorrow morning, 9 o'clock. Wow! Go get them, folks.